114th bank. I wonder what happened to the prior 113 banks. Only this one remains. Interesting.
Thank you.
seems like they're using a lot of these tunnels here in Takamatsu. This street didn't have any other crossing, it seems like. Interesting. We don't have these at all, hardly in Tokyo. By the way, for those of you interested, it is currently, let's see if we can get focus here, maybe not, 11 degrees. It's November 27th and I am walking in Takamatsu City on Shikoku. Now that I've started talking, I might as well continue doing so, right? Anyway, I'm here on an assignment for international media, but right now I'm heading down to this supposedly very beautiful garden a few blocks down here called Ritsu Inn, I think. Let me check. It would be embarrassing if I told you the wrong name. Ritsurin-an garden. So it's a few more blocks down this way. If you're into tires, maybe this will make you happy. Takamatsu is a city of 400 something thousand inhabitants. So it's pretty big. It feels bigger than I expected before coming here. It's located on the coast of Shikoku, on the northern coast, and used to be important because before they built a bridge connecting Shikoku with Honshu, this was like the main entry point. People came here by boat. But since the 80s, there's this big bridge, the Seto Ohashi Bridge. So now I don't think there are many direct connections via boats anymore. There is a ferry from here to Kobe, which I think takes like 4.5 hours. But other than that, I'm not sure if there are many direct ferry connections to the mainland or to Honshu. And it's also, so the water between Shikoku and Honshu is the Seto Inland Sea or Seto Naikai, where there are tons of really, really nice islands, including maybe the most famous of them, which is Naoshima, known for its many art museums, and also there's plenty of famous outdoor artworks that people can enjoy, including the landmark, which is the yellow and black pumpkin by Kusama Yaoi. So it's a quite famous place. It's accessible from here. I think it takes, I don't know, an hour, half an hour by boat to get to Naoshima from Takamatsu. And this city is also famous for udon. Or not really this city, this prefecture, Kagawa Prefecture, is famous for udon.
It's like the udon prefecture of Japan.
So there's like udon shops everywhere in the city.
Although we haven't passed that many on this walk, I think. But in some other areas where I walked earlier, there were like udon shops everywhere. And people here often have udon for breakfast, which seemed a little bit odd to me. But maybe it's good, who knows? Kagawa Prefecture is also the smallest prefecture in all of Japan. So, what that's worth. And it's one of the four prefectures here on Shikoku. I guess it's okay that I talk, considering this stretch that we're walking right now is pretty boring. There's a train. There's not that many train lines here, it seems. It's mostly like streetcars and buses that makes up the public transportation network here. But there are a handful of train lines. I came here by train from Okayama. So to get here from Tokyo, I could either fly or I could go by train. I decided to go for the land-based option, and what I did was I took the Shinkansen to Okayama, which took roughly 3 hours, and then from Okayama I changed to a train that went all the way to Takamatsu via the Seto Ohashi Bridge. So that was another hour or so, and the entire trip costed 18 or 19,000 yen, something like that. So, as I've mentioned before on my streams, I think that traveling within Japan is surprisingly expensive. A flight would have costed even more. It would have been, when I checked, the flights were about 29,000 yen. But of course, there's probably cheaper tickets if you book a bit earlier. There's also some low-cost carriers that flies between Takamatsu and Tokyo. But then you have to go via Narita Airport, which is 2 hours away from the part of Tokyo where I live. So it's not really much of a time saving. But I think if you go for LCC, you can probably fly here for about 10,000 yen. Anyway, I'm pretty sure that this is the garden in here. And judging from Google Maps, there's an entrance a little bit further down this street. I will end this video once I get to the entrance, and then I will make the garden a separate video. So, if you want to see that, you can just... I will put a card up on the screen, maybe right now. You will see the link. Other than that, it should be pretty easy to find it in my feed of videos. I was hoping to be able to capture beautiful afternoon sunlight here in the park, but at least around here it looks like I'm already too late for that. There's actually a big, I don't know if you can see it, but there's a pretty big hill or mountain just behind here. So I guess in order to get the nicer light I should come here at an earlier time. That's a bit of a bummer.
Okay, so they're doing some light up event now, or starting from November 19th. So maybe they're actually open in the evening then. So now it's still too bright for any light ups. I will inquire. Maybe I should come here at night instead then. In the meantime, here we can take a look at a map of the surrounding area. So here is Okayama Prefecture. Obviously we're here now. This is Takamatsu. Here's the bridge, the Seto Ohashi Bridge. And here's Naoshima, the art island that I was talking about, which is very nice, well worth a visit. And if you go there, you should also go to Teshima, which is also a part of this art project that actually extends to several other islands here as well. There's a smaller island called Inujima, which I cannot find right now, but where there's a really cool old abandoned, I think it's some abandoned masonry plant or something like that. Masonry? No, not masonry. What do you call it? Like where they melt the iron ore, or some sort of ore, I think they used to deal with there. But now it's since long abandoned, and instead it has been turned into an art installation or art museum inside. It's pretty cool. Anyway, here, yeah, I think the part that has the kind of stronger color here, that's should be Kagawa Prefecture. So it's a pretty small prefecture. And here's the garden. And here's the bridge. And here's Naoshima. Right, they have a red and black pumpkin as well. This is not the most famous one, but it's quite famous. Anyway, now I completely just started rambling on everything, which probably means that I should end this video now. But okay, so we can conclude that they have actually extended the opening hours until 9 o'clock in the evening. When I checked, it said they close at 5, but I guess they extend it now during the illumination season. So I'm sure there will be another video coming soon where you can see the inside of this place. But for now, I hope you enjoyed this little walk through central Takamatsu. And yeah, I'll see you soon again. Okay.